Hello everyone, welcome to Iteration. I hope you all are taking good care of yourself. In our today's class, we will learn to add textures and graphics in our project file. So without waiting any longer, let's begin today's class. Firstly, we will draw a shape with the help of polygon tool. My shift button is activated to draw straight lines. Let's end the shape here. Activate your select tool. Our shape is ready as it is visible in 3D window as well. Select the fabric option now. In fabric properties, we have one option of texture. If we left click once, one pop-up will appear on the screen. I have one pre-saved texture which can be applied here. The first texture on the screen is the one which we are going to apply. Press OK and it's done now. Our texture is inserted, but now we have to know how we can edit it. You can see three options at the top in our 2D window. First one is graphic 2D pattern, next is transform graphic, and last one is edit texture. We will select edit texture tool. Next step is to select our pattern. As soon you select the pattern, it will highlight like this, which shows the activation for editing. You can see an arrow like line over your pattern. After selecting your pattern again, if you see a circular arrow, then you can rotate your pattern like this. We are doing right now. With the help of left mouse button, we can rotate this pattern. If you select shift, then you will see a little deviation in rotation cause it's moving at the angle of 45 degree. This is all about rotation, but if you wish to increase or decrease the size of your pattern, then you have to go there. If you select the end of this shape and push it inside by left mouse button, the size of the texture will decrease itself, and if you pull it, the size will increase respectively. You can rotate your pattern from here as well. With the help of this, you can decide the cutting grain of the fabric, that is the crosswise or lengthwise. For now, leave it as it is and let's move on to our next option. Right now, our fabric doesn't have any effect, that is the normal map of the fabric. If you open your fabric library, then you can see many default fabrics, and if we add any fabric like cotton canvas on our fabric, then our texture will get deleted and new fabric properties can be seen here. If we import our texture in the place of old one, or should we say new one, then we get this result. With the help of our cotton canvas normal map, we can obtain the real feel of the fabric. You can even create your own normal map, but right now we are not learning that part here. You can go and watch the linked video where you can learn about it. Let's move on to our graphic part now. We have removed our texture now. First, select this graphic 2D pattern tool. I have created many embroidery samples, so we are selecting one of them. As soon you press open, this kind of grid will be visible. You can choose your desired pattern. Well, here we have only one pattern, so no option for us. Press left mouse button to fix the place of the graphic. After that, you can decide the parameters and even the placement of the graphic. By removing this link, you can decide the length and the width of the graphic separately. And if this is on, it will maintain the proportion, like if we write 2 here, this will change accordingly. And if it is not active, this value will not affect the other one. By this way, you can work easily. These are the placement options. Outline will set the distance from the outline of the graphic to the outline of the pattern, and center will set the value from the center of your graphic to the outline of the pattern. And if you are unable to decide right now, you can edit it later as well. Press OK for now. Our graphic is very small in size, so we will start with the resizing first. After selecting your edit graphic tool, you can see a combination of circle and square over your graphic. If you move the mouse to the corner of the square, you can see the resizing symbol. With the help of this, you can work further. It will resize proportionally. You can even resize it lengthwise or crosswise only too. Now we will add normal map in this to achieve the effect of the graphic. This is the normal map for this particular graphic. Apply this. Alongside, we are applying the displacement map from here as well. Displacement map give height to your graphic. Increase the amount of displacement and open your render window from the top. Your graphic is visible in render window. As you can see in our 3D window, the same graphic is very subtle, but you can see the real look of it from our render window now. By these steps, you can create any embellishment and patches. All you have to do is add your graphic and its normal and displacement map. Then change the displacement amount and you are done. This is all for today's class. Hope this will help you while working. See you in next class. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to our channel. Also press the bell icon to receive the notification of new video. You can also follow us on Instagram and Facebook. Join our Facebook group to connect with more people. And if you have any query, write it in the comment box below. Thank you all.